The guest of today doesn't need any introduction. You already met him yesterday and the day before. But I would like to thank once more Walter Murch to be with us, and I let him bring the talk.
We are in a period of great change because of digital. The active imagination that you have to do is less with digital on many, many levels. You can see dissolves instantly. You can see certain visual effects instantly. This has certain advantages. This is me also in Argentina, editing a Francis Coppola film. Here there was the luxury, thanks to digital, of having an editing room that was also the projection room. You can see the screen over on the left side. I had a kind of a visceral reaction against the normal kind of what we might call Hollywood editing. The editor putting the film together is translating the film from the language of text of the script to the language of images and sound in time. They want everyone to come together to be inspired and to inspire each other. And inspire the director and show the director things that weren't even in the director's mind, but that the director can recognize as being a brilliant idea. Sometimes the director will say, that's just what I had in mind, only it's even better than I imagined. But then also the opposite happens, and the director will say, thank you, that's exactly what I didn't want. I'm working on Adobe Premiere. This is the first film that I've edited using the Premiere system. The nickname in the industry for Adobe's system is Final Cut 8, which is to say the system that would have happened had Apple not killed Final Cut and gone to this other system, Final Cut 10. I began editing films standing up. So that's a factor. That Moviola that you saw in the picture is a machine that works best when you're standing at it like this, but they are desks and they encourage you to sit down. And of course, when I first used them, I did sit down at them. And yet I felt something was wrong. My nickname for it was Steenbeck Neck, because all I was moving was my wrist. But I see a scene evolving like a tree that at a certain point puts out a branch, and that's the cut. Why do we choose there to put out a branch? And then at a certain point in the branch, it puts out another branch, and finally it puts out the leaf. When I get the material back from the laboratory, or just now digital, when it comes in from the camera department, I screen it, of course, take notes, and then go through it and select certain frames that, to me, answer the question, why did they shoot this shot? That moment where you go from one shot to the other is memorized by the audience in a subconscious way. And those are, in an ideal sense, those images at the moment of transition are the more iconic, revealing images. Thank you very much.